On behalf of the people of Schuylkill County, my colleague Jerry Knowles and myself, it is a great honor to be here today, Mr. Speaker, because today we say goodbye to a longtime friend, Brian Rooney, who is retiring after nearly 35 years of service in the Pennsylvania House of Representatives. Brian, who is not only a constituent of mine, but a good friend, is proof that hard work and dedication pays off. As the Speaker mentioned, Brian started as a page back in 1981, and he rose quickly through the ranks, and today is Legislative Service Manager, a position he held since 2012. Brian supervises the office that accepts amendments, assigns bill numbers, and prepares the calendar and voting schedule, as the Speaker mentioned. Brian and the people around him play a critical role in the day-to-day operations of the House. Mr. Speaker, as a former staff member for 12 years myself, I know firsthand the dedication and hard work of our staff on both sides of the aisle. They are the ones working behind the scenes that keep this institution running smoothly. The public rarely sees how much time and effort they put into their jobs, but we all know as members that we could not do our job if it was not for the dedication of these professionals. Many of us know Brian for his work here in Harrisburg, but sometimes he finds the time, and I don't know how, to devote to his hometown of Shenandoah, Pennsylvania. He coached midget football in Little League for many years. He also served as a member of Phoenix Firehouse, the Glover Hill Social Club, and the Shenandoah Valley High School Quarterback Club. As the Speaker mentioned, he is also a devoted family member, and I know his family personally, and I can tell you they come from good stock and are fine people, all of them. So Brian, on behalf of my colleagues in the Pennsylvania House of Representatives, we extend to you our heartfelt congratulations upon your well-deserved retirement and hope that you will not be a stranger and that you, in your retirement, we wish you Godspeed and all your future endeavors, and don't hesitate to stop by every once in a while and see us. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Brian, we present you with this gavel, and please feel free to take the rostrum to say any words you may want to express. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. It was very kind words. I just want to say how much of an honor it is to work for you under your leadership, and both sides of the aisle. For 35 years now, I've been looking at a lot of old pictures, house floor pictures, just pictures that we've taken over the years up here. And I've come to realize I work with a lot of great people, past and present. I mean, when you think about how many people have crossed through here, either as a staffer or as a representative, or a leader. There's a lot of great people. And there's one other thing I realized was, at one time, I had a lot of hair. But I learned that you surround yourself with good people, you get good work, and they make you look good. A few years back, Assistant Chief Clerk Linda Lehman asked me to do her a favor. And I said, sure, what is it? She said, I have these two guys who want you to supervise them. And I said, okay. She said, what are their names? And she said, Dave Spazieri and Lynn Bias. And I said, sure, no problem. Is there a problem? She said, yeah, they don't know how to tell time. And I said, they don't know how to tell time? And she said, yeah, they're always leaving at 4:15.
Thank you.
I gave you up. But I have to thank the guys that do make me look good. And Spiz and Lynn are two of them. But over here, you got Ricky Bresky, Jason Nace, Al Hunt, and Dave Binkley, you never see, but he's the workhorse down in the office. Coming across the aisle, Billy Jones. Billy and I have been together for 34 years, side by side. Whatever you ask him, he does. He filled in probably at every spot up here at one time or another. I'd say, hey, Billy, we need you to do the roll call clerk's job today. And he says, okay, show me the money. Polly Brungard, he's the new message clerk. Polly's dad, he's fallen in Polly's dad's shoes, and good guys. I want to thank Lori and Zach for their candy bars. I'm sure nobody saw the candy bars they made, but they have my face on it anyway. Jordan Davis, he's the new Brian Rooney. He's going to take over as manager for legislative services. And for 15 years, I sat next to Gina Regno here. So she asked me, if, whoever gets promoted, make sure they're young and good looking. This guy right here, you know, he's here a short time. He's a great leader, Dave Redcliffe. I've had a lot of great chief, I've worked with all my chief clerks I've worked for were great people. My assistant chief clerks that I worked for are all great. And one way or another, they all helped me out moving up the ladder. And one chief clerk in particular was Ted Mazia. He called me up one day in a stern voice, and he said, if I send one more person down for a free Thanksgiving Day turkey, I'm paying for them. But Jess and the girls from downstairs and all the speaker staff and leader staff, I can't tell you how much I appreciate their help. I worked with Lori Lichetto, I don't know how many years now. It's just been a privilege working with Lori. But I just want to say thanks for everything. And I have a beautiful family. I love them very much. But there's a little, I'll cut it short because they have me on the clock. If you don't, if you see that. they said 45 minutes. I didn't think I was going to be able to talk that much, but. I'm just so proud of my family. And I want to leave you with a part of an Irish prayer. Until we meet again, may God hold you in the palm of his hand. Happy Easter.